In this lecture, I will solve the chain problem where chain is kept on a hemisphere. I want to find the velocity of chain when the top part comes here at this point. That is basically chain is occupying a quarter of the ring. It is like a ring, it is quarter of the ring. Though it is kept on a hemisphere, but if you look at the chain, it's like quarter of a ring. So the length of chain is 2 pi r upon 4, which is pi r upon 2. And let lambda be mass per unit length, m upon l be lambda. I can solve this problem by energy method and by differential equation. Energy method is very easy for this. I will try to use differential equation just to expose you to that kind of method and to remove that fear of differential equation in such problems. It will just help in building the confidence in dealing with such variables. Now, first of all, in such problems, now here, when I remove the thread, what will happen is this part will start going down. And at any given point of time, say it will have this kind of a position. Now, my alpha is a variable here. It keeps on varying. It will keep on varying. To solve this in a differential equation mode, let me take this segment only. Let me call it as a x segment of the chain, and let me call it as y segment of the chain. Now for x segment of chain, I want to know what is the force which is acting because of its own weight. You see, its weight is acting in a tangential way at all the places tangent to the hemisphere. So talking in terms of force for such situation may not be useful, so I'll talk in terms of torque, because force is acting tangential, so I'll multiply force by the radius and I want to get what is the total torque acting on x because of the weight of x. Forget this part right now. I will join them at a point where the tension T is acting between the two, and I'm not bothered at this point. I'm just looking at point x, at the x part, what is the torque because of its own weight. And to do that, let us take a small segment in this. Let me redraw the diagram so that we don't get confused with the main diagram. And let me take a small segment, some small segment, which is of this much angle. Pi by 2 minus alpha is the total angle this segment is making. Each will have small elements dm, 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 and it will add up to its total weight. And that will give it a torque. For doing that, let me now take another angle within this. It is slightly, but many times you need x within x, y within y. You have to do that. But don't think it's very difficult. It's easy. And I take theta and d theta. So this segment is r d theta is my this small segment. Now let me draw the diagram for that small segment. That small segment is, now don't confuse with alpha, I'm talking about that segment which is at angle theta. And that segment is subtending an angle d theta. Here, d theta is the angle made here. And the angle of this segment with the vertical is theta. Don't confuse with alpha. Alpha was the limiting angle for this segment, whole segment. This is small mass dm. Its weight will be in this direction, and this direction I can resolve the components along the normal. This is dmg. Now I want tangential, so this angle I can write, this angle will be alpha. Because whenever you drop a perpendicular, if there are two lines having angle theta, and if you drop perpendicular to both the lines, this is perpendicular to this line, this is perpendicular to this line, perpendiculars also make the same angle theta. You must be knowing it, I thought I'll just mention. So this component is dmg sine alpha. This is giving it a small torque, which I can write d torque as dm g sine, not alpha, theta, sorry, sine theta into R. I multiply this force by R, I get the torque. What is the value of dm? dm would be lambda times R d theta, where lambda is mass per unit length. So lambda R d theta into g into R into sine theta is my torque. I integrate it, and my theta is varying from alpha to pi by 2. My theta is varying from starting from alpha and less than pi by 2. Within this segment I was working, so alpha to pi by 2. Alpha to pi by 2. So I got my total torque as lambda r square g cos theta, which will be in minus, from alpha to pi by 2. So I get lambda r square g cos alpha. So for any segment which makes alpha with the vertical, that segment will give it this much of torque. So this is a general equation which I have got. Now let me write the equation for the angular acceleration of this part. Now angular acceleration of x, mass of x, this much part is having some mass, and this is having mass y, and this is having mass x. I will later on write. Its moment of inertia will be, it's like a ring, so its mass times the radius square is the moment of inertia of this part. And the total torque acting on this part is 1 because of this. And then there's a tension here in between them. So tension also providing it a force and a torque. So the total torque is moment of inertia times angular acceleration is equal to the total torque, which is lambda r square g cos alpha plus t times r. So it becomes mx r into alpha is lambda r g cos alpha plus t. This is my x, mass of x. What is r alpha? R alpha is nothing but the tangential acceleration, and that tangential acceleration will be same as the acceleration of y. So I write it as acceleration, common acceleration of both, I replace it by acceleration. Now I write equation for this part. M y into a is equal to, what is helping its movement is m y g, its weight, minus the tension. Tension is upwards for this part, if you look at this part only, and this was the joining point, so it is tension is upward for this part. But when I was looking at the upper part, the tension was downwards, and this is the joining point. So this is the equation which I get. Add these two, you get mx plus my into a is equal to, t gets cancelled, you get myg plus lambda rg cos alpha. Mx plus my is the total mass, and total mass will be lambda times L, which is equal to lambda times pi r upon 2. So this becomes lambda pi r upon 2 is the mass of the chain into the acceleration. And what was my? My was, this length is how much? R alpha. Lambda r alpha is my g plus lambda r g cos alpha. So you get lambda r g as common, alpha plus cos alpha is the equation, and here you get pi lambda pi r a upon 2. So let me simplify it further. Let me eliminate lambda and let me eliminate r. So this becomes, a becomes twice g upon pi alpha plus cos alpha is the acceleration of my chain when it makes an angle alpha. So what is the tangential velocity here in terms of angle alpha? V tangential is d r d alpha upon dt. I can write it here as this. And acceleration, how can I write acceleration? Is dv tangential upon dt is equal to twice g upon pi alpha plus cos alpha. I might have missed, I hope, though it has not been missed, maybe something in the answer. So that is not more important. What is more important, I'm just trying to show you the method. Because so many things are there and to err is a human. So now this is the equation I've got. In such equations, when you get in mechanics, always use this thing. Like I get dv upon dt, I write it as dv upon dx into dx upon dt. Here there is no x, it is actually here it is curve, here it is straight. So instead of x, I write s. dv upon dt can be written as dv upon ds into ds upon dt. dv upon ds, ds upon dt is what? Is v tangential? Is ds upon dt? And what is ds? Ds I can write, ds is r d alpha. Ds will be r d alpha, small angle. D alpha times r makes the distance ds. So now I make these, but this is a standard method. Always follow this when you get in terms of acceleration, write acceleration in terms of velocity and dv divide by the distance. If it is a simple linear motion, x or y, if it's this kind of a motion, then take ds. So I write v tangential into dv tangential, this is tangential only, divide by ds. Ds is r times d alpha, is this I remove, twice g upon pi alpha plus cos alpha. So I get vt dvt as twice g r upon pi, r I have taken there, and d alpha also, alpha d alpha plus cos alpha d alpha. And I integrate it. My chain started when alpha was 0. So it is from 0 to pi by 2. Because this is a general expression I have written. You have to take from the starting point. So alpha was from 0 to pi by 2. This will become Vt. I don't know whether it is visible. Vt square upon 2 is equal to twice g r upon pi. This becomes alpha square upon 2 plus sine alpha. Alpha is varying from 0 to pi by 2. So this becomes, let me write it here, Vt square by 2 is equal to twice g r upon pi, and this becomes pi square upon 8 plus 1. So it becomes Vt square is 4 g r upon pi, pi square plus 8 upon 8, which is g r upon twice pi into pi square plus 8 is my Vt square, or Vt will be equal to square root of gr pi square plus 8 upon twice pi. Now let us try this using the energy method, which is very simple. This was very lengthy, but it is required to overcome the fear of the differential equation and variables. It is variable within variable. Once you do it, then you get used to it. Now let me do it using the energy method, which is very easy. In case of energy method, just take this position and take the reference from here, the top part. In such cases where chain is falling, take the reference instead of bottom, take it top. It is more convenient. That is point number one. Now chain is here initially. What is the total length of chain? Is 2 pi r upon 4, which is pi r upon 2. Is the total length of chain. What is the mass? Mass is lambda pi r upon 2. Is the mass of this chain at this position. What is the distance of its center of gravity from the top? This height I need to know. So it is important for you to remember the center of gravity of some basic shapes like ring, disc, hemisphere, solid sphere. It is very handy and useful. For ring, for half ring, the center of gravity from the base, if this is a ring, the full ring has the center of gravity from this base is twice r upon pi. And this is r minus twice r upon pi. So it is r 1 minus 2 upon pi is this distance. If you take half, its center of gravity is not going to change. So it is same, which is r minus twice r upon pi, which was r 1 minus 2 upon pi, is your h1, is the center of gravity. And take all the distances down when you are writing potential energy as negative. I have taken reference above, so take your distances down as negative. What is the potential energy of this segment now? Potential energy of this segment will be the weight, which is lambda pi r into 2 into g. And what is the distance of the center of gravity? It is in negative, so it is minus r 1 minus 2 upon pi. Is the potential energy initially. So I write ui. When the chain falls down, when the chain is here, this distance is r. Its midpoint will be pi r upon 4. So this distance is pi r upon 4. So its center of gravity is at r 1 plus pi upon 4. Is its center of gravity. What is the mass of this segment? Mass is same as the earlier segment. So the final energy will be potential energy of this plus the kinetic energy of this because it is now moving. So what is the potential energy? In that reference frame only, it is minus r 1 plus pi upon 4 is the distance of center of gravity. And what its weight is lambda pi r upon 2 into g is the potential energy plus what is the velocity kinetic energy half and weight is lambda pi r upon 2 half m into v square. Total energy initial and final has to be common, so equate them. Minus 2 upon pi is equal to minus r 1 plus pi upon 4 into g plus half v square, because this one I have eliminated, the mass I have just eliminated. So this is what I get by equating. So you bring this on the left side, you get gr common 1 plus pi upon 4 minus 1 plus 2 upon pi is equal to v square upon 2. So you get gr times this gets cancelled, and here you get pi square plus 8 upon 4 is equal to v square upon 2. So v you get as, this gets cancelled here too, v you get as, and there is pi here, so gr upon pi, gr upon 2 pi into pi square plus 8. And if you can compare, it is same relationship we have got by the differential equation. Gr pi square plus 8 upon 2 pi is the solution to this problem.